God is awesome. We can't stop blessing Him that we seated. We can't stop worshiping Him. He does great and mighty things that only God can do. Father, I celebrate you. I was only here yesterday, I was revived. I got a new flame, a new strength. The energy we saw here yesterday was something else. So those of you that are doing like an old person like me, begin to adjust. Because the flight is about to take off. There's no something I'll be bringing the word of God. And it's titled, Our True Prayers. Amen. Becoming a high flyer. Strictly, we're going to turn our Bibles to the word of God. Numbers 13, verses 17 to 21. Then I read 30. Then we take it to 14. I read verses just 6 to 9. This morning, as you speak, O God, through me, I'm just this verse. Come. This is the word of the Lord to the youth this morning. I know there are obstacles on the way. I know there are challenges. The completion is deep. But the word of God to you this morning, He said, go up at once without delay. He said, possess it, for you are well able. Who is he that speaketh? And it cometh to pass when God has not spoken. Who has told you as a youth, as any man, any woman, seated in this sanctuary, that you are limited, you are not able to do it. It's a fat lie. If God says possess it, I pray that the youth in the house will catch what God has for you this day, and your life will never be the same again. In the name of Jesus. Quickly, we move from chapter 14 of same Numbers. Land. Youth in the house, Nigeria is extremely good land. There are opportunities to tap. There are breakthroughs in the land. That is what the word of God is saying. Then in verse 7 and in verse 8, if the Lord delights in us, I know you know God delights in you. So it's well able to give you the land. It's well able to give you the spouse. It's well able to give you the career. It's well able to mind that business for you. Because God delights in us. He's able to bring you to a land. A land which flows with milk and honey. Only rebel ye not against the Lord. Neither fear the people. Our item for a while has been, I'm no longer slave to fear. I don't know how many of you have been blessed by that ministration. It has turned me around 360 degrees. I'm no longer fear. Worried. Ah, what if I fail? What if I succeed? I'm no longer slave to fear. Don't be afraid to step out as a youth. Take the bull by the horn. You have the physical energy. You need the spiritual energy to get those things done. Tap into it and be your best. Hallelujah. Do not rebel against the laws. Their defense is departed from them. When God wants to help you, He takes away the defense of your adversary. He makes them naked. You begin to walk as giants. You are walking in darkness. The adversary is not seeing you because God has taken the strength of your adversary. So you are not intimidated. Do not fear. If you still have fear in your life, settle it that this weekend, in this service, in this day, there will be a change. You begin to tackle new things. You begin to do new things. You begin to walk in dominion, in authority. The song I wanted to sing was, we are a chosen generation. Youth, you're called forth to show forth the light of God. Who called you out of darkness into the marvelous light? You are in the kingdom where things happen. Pastor said, we are not born again to suffer again. I'm not born again to suffer again. I'm the daughter of the Most High. You are the son, the daughter of the Most High. So things will change. It's not the same status quo, the way it used to be. Things are changing. Powers are changing high. Are changing hands for us to be high flyers. God will help us in the name of Jesus. But you know, it's not just like that. It's not that easy. That's why we get it, no? Jittery, angry. If you can discover how, you can recover all. People of God, one thing you do this morning is to discover first. Then you recover all. Being a high flyer is not accidental. You don't wish it. You don't dream it. You walk it. What you cannot see, what your heart cannot perceive, your head cannot get. So you have to visualize, think, make it work. This morning, because I'm speaking to you especially, rich or poor, to be successful or a mediocre, to be a beggar, to rely on religions to keep sending you funds, where you can be a financial controller, where you can be a voice in the house of the Lord, where you can be respected and honored, it depends on what you want. So every youth in the house, you're a student, you're a business, you're a job, you're a career, you have a plan check, so you can begin to work now. 5 to 10 years, will your life count? Will you be impactful? That is a question for you to answer. Hence, your fame is there, your wealth, your recognition. Imagine that everybody respects your contribution to the society, the nation, and the world at large, simply by the power of the supernatural. That we are centering this morning. But before then, I want to lay a foundation on just a few principles. Principles are good, but they are not the ultimate, because you are children of the kingdom. So we do it the kingdom way. In life, one of the discoveries I've made is that life works on principles. It works for everybody, irrespective of age, your race, your nationality, your location. If you can't walk in Lagos and beat the hectic traffic, you might not work in the US. Because most of their job is hourly. So it's not like here, we are tired, you take a break. If you take a break, in advanced countries, your finances are taking break. Because they will pay you nothing for non-productivity. So, if it's a principle of decision making, youth, I told you, have a plan check. You now know where to face. You now know where to direct your energy. God will help you. You saw the report. Caleb said the land is good. It flows with milk and honey. Nigeria is possible. I will get us job. It's train us. I will rise in this career. That is your choice. That is your decision. Because you have seen it in your heart, determines how far you go. Hallelujah. Then, remember that life does not give you what you deserve. It's never a fair playing terrain. Life gives to you what you decide. Like I talked about decision about Jesus. Then the principle of focus. I'll say this creates blindness to what is not necessary. I'm speaking to youth especially this morning. These days we have children 17 years in uni, and at that age 17, year one. It will be lack of focus for a 17 years undergrad to be thinking of relationship. What's the essence of university education? To read. But when they have relationship, not all can handle both. One will suffer. Especially when it's not a good relationship that, you know, emotions are used negatively. So, law of focus. Focus on what you need to get. Get it and you're done. The word of God was saying in Isaiah 50 verse 17. He said, because the Lord is with me, I know I will not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like a flint. A flint is like a rock. Does rock turn? If you go to Joss Hill, it's there. Since I was little, Joss Hill has been there, still there. Set your face like a flint. In that career, don't be a jack of all and a master of none. Locate one thing. Be an expert. Be a sought after. Let the world look for you. Let the world hire you. Focus. You can't be in a career you're not writing professional exams. You're not going for your masters. You're not advising. You're not doing any seminar. You're just there. Small children will come and overtake. And when they begin to make them bosses in the office, they begin to build a business. Well, that's where people begin to get tired, discouraged, and depressed. But God gave us a plan check to determine what we want early enough. Then, another thing I want us to look at, I'm not going through all this. Vision. Don't lose touch of it. It's part of focus. That's why I say place it. Habakkuk was speaking in Habakkuk 2:1-3. He said, write the vision down. Make it plain on the table. That he that runs with it will, he that reads it will run. When you wake up and see what you have placed, oh, I've not gotten this. God, help me. Let it be achieved. Things begin to change in your life. May we not remain where we have found 2 years ago. In the name of Jesus. God will help our youth in the house this morning. In the name of Jesus. Then the principle of working hard and working smart. Proverbs 22 verse 29. See, as that way, man, diligent in his work. He will not. You'll be wondering, this man don't know. There's no sponsor. There's nobody to help me. Step out. Somebody will locate you. Don't just sit down there and do nothing. There are people that are being trained by total strangers. Yes. God can do all things. Look at that. People that can help us. But if you can get to the source, it becomes a lot easier. And the flow becomes more consistent. You don't need to be waiting. You don't need to have just 15 naira left in your pocket before the next supply comes. Connect to God. Time will not permit me to Luke 18:1-9. It talks about the widow. She went to the church. It's her 20th of my adversary. She kept praying. The man refused. But that consistent prayer turned things around. It's not going to time we wait. We pray. We stand up and go. We have not heard. We have not received. We have not received direction. Every one of us in the house, you must pray, listen, and get direction to know what next. Prayer doesn't put money in people's pockets. It's the direction you receive. It's the business it tells you to do that will help you get that money. So you must get direction. That is one thing about prayer. Then know that getting direction is even more difficult than praying. Everybody can pray. Not everybody gets direction. So be sensitive. Connect well so that there is no leakage. You get what you want to get to what you're going. Then again, be obedient to the word. Destroy every mindset. I was saying something yesterday. When the word of God comes, it might be foolish. But then be consistent with God. Recently, was it 3 weeks ago? I got a news that was not pleasant. It broke me, shattered me. I wept. And I transferred the aggression to my husband. For 1 week, it was fire. Because that thing broke me. I spent money. I was looking for a particular document from Lagos State. So when they called me that I didn't say true, I was down and out. After I licked my wound, I moved on. Do you know that instead of me to be praising God, I was sad. But do you know what happened? Just on Monday, it was Pastor's birthday. Somebody walked in and gave me a wine. 1 hour later, brother, one in this church, says his birthday. I said, oh, God bless you. Second wine came. I said, today is special. I called my sister. I said, today is special. They've never given me 2 bottles of wine in a day. I got two on my birthday, my husband's birthday, I got 2 wine. There's something special. I went to the kitchen to cook. I got a call. Are you this? I said, yes. It's okay, you've been considered for what you applied for. I could not believe it. A miracle, I fasted and prayed for 2 whole years. They called me. I couldn't believe. Ah! I danced, I rolled on the floor. I called my sister, said, God has done it. After dancing, I began to tap. I said, maybe they are 419. They said, I should come with 150,000 to pick up this document. I couldn't wait for my husband to come. He no answer to you. He said, they're generating the paper. I can't just pay. I need a document to pay. This is a government coffer. So there's a trace. I was still shaking. In the office, I was not myself. People come and ask me questions. I tell them, eh? It was not a pastor. I called him. I said, my husband, 1 o'clock, from 9 o'clock. He not presented it. What am I saying? There are victories God has won. All you and I need is grace to get it out. That was what happened to me. Even I was so down that my sister here challenged me. He said, what is wrong with you? Why are you feeling like this? I said, you don't understand. Look at the money spent. Look at all the sufferings I've been through. I'm just tired. And some of you are like me. Your miracles are already cooked. It's being said. You are about to take delivery, but you are angry. At times, the enemy will even make us lose it. But God saved me that God did not allow me to lose it. He gave me what I was looking for. Hallelujah. Be full of praise. Time will not allow me. The last thing I'll say to the youth, begin to ask God for the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of counsel, the spirit of knowledge, the spirit of might, the spirit of power. Now you need energy. If you want to build a business, start in your late 20s, start in your early 30s. If you want to get old like me now, the strength might not be there. There are things I did before with this, I can't do them. Start early, and it gives you time to recover. The business I'm doing was not flourishing the way it is now, years back. What helped me? Time. I was able to stabilize so that I can take shots. Hallelujah. Start telling. And God will help us in Jesus' name. Begin to ask God to help you as a youth. Begin to ask you. That power to take right decision is the most important thing that will happen to every decision. The spirit of wisdom, the power of God, the counsel of God in your God has already put in provision left, right, and center to make sure that you don't fall. And my brother did yet. No situation is impossible. No situation is not surmountable. That's why you need the spirit of God to tell you what to do per minute per time. Stop being complacent. Stop praying that you wake up, somebody will dash you money. If they dash us money, it's good, it's not the best. Hallelujah. You must do something. You say the house, my prayer this morning is that you will arise. You will shine. The glory of God is upon you. You will move from glory to glory. Your youthful years will not be wasted. Now that you have strength, you make use of it. You will count in the matter of things. When people are counting money, you will not be giving suggestions. You put that in your pocket and pay your bills. In the name of Jesus. The God of glory will position you in a place that you are visible for help. There are so many that are working hard, but what you lack is favor. I pray in the name of resurrected Jesus, let the favor that makes life easy rest upon our youth and our singles. In the name of Jesus. Amen. You know not well in obscurity. You will walk in the light of God. God will move you higher beyond your imagination. Every youth in the house will be found. None will be stranded. In the name of Jesus. Amen. You will arise and shine. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.